in this triangle here, this word problem here, we're looking at a triangular pyramid with a square base. We're given some information and a drawing of it, okay? So the base of the pyramid has sides that are 30 centimeters in length, so that's all the way around. That means this, 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 and this. These are all 30 centimeters. And the distance from the top of the pyramid to each corner is 20 centimeters. In other words, the distance from the top of the pyramid, so that's up here, to each corner of the base is 20. So that's, let's say it could be C, or it could be B, it could be A, it could be D. Okay, they're all going to be the same value. So I'll just do EC. I'm going to highlight that, maybe this with this marker here. Let me maybe take off the black outline and put in the red. There we go. And that is our 20 centimeters. Now, it is labeled 22 in the diagram because it is an error. Now, what is the error? Is it 22 or is it 20? I'm going to go with 20. Okay. And I'll tell you right now, this was an error and I decided to leave it in because it'll kind of show us how, you know, when solving word problems, it is always good to look at the reasonableness of your answer in the context of the entire question. Okay, the correct length of that side is 22, but I'm going to go ahead as if it were 20, okay, because I want to purposely, you know, run into an error, and we'll see when that arises very quickly. Okay, so the first part of this question says determine the angle each side makes with the base. So what they're saying here is if you see this triangle here on the inside, let me outline it for you. One sec. Okay. This is like a triangle, you know, that's the height from the, you know, the top to the bottom. You know, it's a perpendicular. And I have this over here. And then I have this side over here. And this triangle is kind of like traced on the inside of the pyramid. Okay. And what happens is because it's on the inside, you know, this length across is still going to be 30, but I'm dividing it in half. So I'm going to get, you know, over here, I'm going to get 15 centimeters. And I don't know the height of that triangle, which is this guy here. And I don't know this hypotenuse, okay, either. And I'm trying to figure out what this angle is here. Let's call it, I'll call it angle G, okay. Again, that there is some ambiguity because angle G could be, you know, this angle on the side, could be this angle, which is the same anyways. But I'll call it angle G. Okay, so I'll call it angle G here. So in order to use SOHCAHTOA, because I think that's the natural idea I want to employ here, given that I have a right angle triangle, I need to have, you know, at least one more piece of information, and that base doesn't cut it. However, if we look to this triangle here, this kind of one that's like resting on the side, right? It's half of the side of the pyramid. It is also a right angle triangle. Okay, so I can put like a 90 degrees over here. And because I know that this is 30, when I drop the perpendicular or the altitude, given that this is an isosceles triangle, okay, I'm dividing that base in two. So what happens here is I get 15. Okay. Looks good. Now I think I have enough information. Okay. This side triangle here to solve for, you know, the question mark, which is the hypotenuse of, you know, the original triangle I'm trying to solve for. And it's one of the sides of the pyramid, or half the side of one of the pyramids. So let's go about trying to solve for that value. And I'm going to give it a letter here. Let's call it, do we have an X in there? No. Let's call it X. Okay. And again, I'm using this triangle here on the side with the 20, which is a mistake. And I'm telling you that ahead of time. So let's solve for X. I'm going to do, well, just straightforward Pythagorean theorem because I have two sides and I need to find the third. So I'm going to set my equation up. I have X squared plus 15 squared equals 20 squared, and if I do the math, I get x squared plus 225 equals 400. X squared equals 400 minus 225, which is 175. So when I take the square root of that, I'll get x equals, and I'll have to plug my calculator. Actually, you know what? It's going to do this on the side. I'm trusting that you know how to take the square root of a number. But when I do that, I get 175. The square root of that number is 13.2. So 13.2. And I'm going to write that in right now, 13.2, for my x value. And maybe you can already see what the error is. It's a bit too thick. Try that. 13.2. Let's pause and take a look at this internal triangle. The hypotenuse is 13.2. One of the non-hypotenutinal sides, if that's even a word, is 15. Can the hypotenuse ever be longer than a side? I don't think so. And that is the internal inconsistency of this problem when you assume a value of 20 for this side. Okay? And because of that, this is wrong, and we have to go back to the drawing board and state the correct initial condition, which is 22 centimeters. Okay, this is still 15 here at the bottom. That doesn't change. This 15 doesn't change. Okay, it's consistent with the labeling of the diagram, but the 20 was not. Okay, and I'm going to use 22 now to redo this calculation. Okay, all I have to do is replace the 0 with a 2, and 422 squared is 484, and I'm going to skip all the other steps over here. Again, I hope you can do them on your calculator. I get an x value of square root of 44, 22. Sorry, not 44. It's 44 minus 225. Is 16.1. And that is our side, or our hypotenuse, and that is greater than 15, so we can go on and solve for angle G. And for that, I'm going to use SOHCAHTOA. I think cosine is the best candidate here. So I have cos of G equals 15 over 16.1. So G equals cos inverse of whatever that is, which equals, I'll do it on my calculator again at the side, 21.2 degrees, or 21, whatever you're comfortable with. Great. Okay, so we have our angle, 21.2. I'm going to zoom in here and make that change. So I'm just going to write 21 degrees. And the second part is find the height of the square base pyramid. Well, that's pretty easy, because now I can just use the tan of 21 is equal to h over 15. And when you do the math, again, I'm going to let you do it. I get 5.75, or I'll just say approximately 5.8, and that is centimeters. Finally, angle theta, that's this guy over here. I think we again have enough information. That's 15 as well, over here, right? So I can just use this side triangle with, you know, tan inverse, I believe. So tan theta is going to be 16.1 over 15. Theta equals tan inverse of whatever that is. And I'll do it on my calculator. And I get 47 degrees, 47.02, that's good enough. Okay, so there's a question Again, I think the most illustrating part, other than understanding the three-dimensional nature of it, is being able to identify when you have an error, an inconsistency, an internal inconsistency, and rejig your problem accordingly so that everything kind of hangs together. Again, all these answers that I've, come up with in these parts, they all kind of corroborate, the evidence given, the information given in the question. Okay, they don't contradict it. Okay, and as a result, I'm more inclined to, believe the reasonableness of my answer. Of course, I can always be wrong. That is never out of question.